Welcome to Konoha Corner, Naruto for the big kids, and maybe some adults. I'm Gothic Gara.
I'm Sai.
I'm Pain.
I'm Haku.
I'm Sasori.
I'm Toby.
I'm Kakazu.
I'm Sakura.
I'm Tamari.
I'm Choji.
I'm Ino.
I'm Hinata.
I'm Naruto.
And I'm Jiraiya.
I'm Doctor from the Ass Backwards Anime Podcast.
I'm going to love my nana. I'm going to be the king of Pride Rock.
Black and White come out tomorrow, and I don't have the money to purchase either.
I don't either.
It's Black and White.
I have a zebra.
Mine for
You're not funny.
Then why are you laughing?
Shut up.
We've got surprise papes.
I got a shit.
What the fuck? Right here, right now, number two? Really?
There's no way we're keeping that.
That's gonna be... No, you gotta pay for that shit.
I don't wanna pay the shit.
I would never pay for that.
Until I...
Until you I think that's your fourth
Oh, I like it.
Yeah. Now I think you're just trying to do it on purpose.
No, that one was actually... I stopped and I read at the same time and I didn't come out of my mouth.
Just give me...
Bacon.
Bacon!
Bacon.
Bacon.
We've had our first official bacon statement of the podcast.
I remember. Oh, no, I don't.
I read it and I almost was going to say thank you for thrusting me.
Wow.
That's
why did you not say that?
It was funny in my brain.
The word pudding sounds funny to you, Naruto.
Pudding is chocolate which goes in my mouth. Mm.
Welcome, everybody, to Toby's Tales.
Da-dum!
Fuck off!
No!
Farewell, you goddamn pubes.
Farewell, pubes.
Farewell, pubes. I knew you well.
Not really.
Thanks for being gay. Oh, fuck off.
I love the way he just said
I am so gay.
Masturbation makes you gay. Shit. At 10 years old, I was a flaming queer.
Just in time, Toby's Tales, man.
I don't know what we're talking about, and I can't improv
right now. He's trying to write this shit right now. Give him a minute.
I will poop on you, Doctor, but I will.
What? Oh, snap. Suddenly this bitch has fucking fangs.
This is the stuff that we are going to charge people to listen to.
So hello and welcome to episode 132 of Konoha Corner. That's right, it's the end of the year. So next year is going to either be the greatest thing ever or it's going to be the biggest catastrophe mankind has ever seen and we're all going to die.
Yay!
If I have a hand in it, it might be the second one.
Yeah. If Toby has anything to do with it.
You can blame my people for that one.
I get it.
As we're all being set on fire by the sun flare that's supposed to cook us all. I'm going to be screaming, damn you, doctor, and relatives.
Well, at least you'll be able to fill my, life dream of becoming a living, french fry.
Maybe.
It'll be the first time in the entirety of his existence that someone can point at Toby and say, hey, you're a flamer.
What? All I know is that if this happens, I'll finally complete my lifelong dream about being one of the Fantastic Four. I should jump off.
I'm starting to wonder if maybe that's what the Moon's Eye plan is all about. It's just about stopping global warming.
In which case, should we let it even happen?
No. Not his way.
Okay, not his way.
We all want to die eventually.
No one wants to let Toby be the person that casts Mangekyo on the world. Then we'll all be obsessed with lobsters and headbands.
Then we'll all be idiots.
And Muffin.
All right. So, yeah, this is the last episode of the year, so that means by the time you hear this episode, it'll probably either be right before the end of the year or actually next year. So, fun stuff. Wanted to just say how happy I am that I had time during this holiday to get caught up, because 131 actually went up just a couple of hours ago, so we're actually current on the podcast for once. Woohoo! For the first time in four fucking months. Wait till the end of the year, then we finally catch up. But yeah, hopefully this episode, I've got two things. I've got to edit Pervy Place and this. So you guys definitely look forward to Pervy Place. That's going to be really, really cool. I'll probably give this episode priority over Pervy Place and then post Pervy Place next. But it'll probably only take me about a day to get all of this done, because I've been like in Uber work mode for some reason. So it's been crazy but fun at the same time. So yeah, good stuff. We got quite a bit of news. Psy is back on British time, like normal person's British time, if you know, when they're living over there. So he's not actually up in the middle of the morning. He's actually getting up at decent hours, which means they're crap hours for the rest of us. So I'll probably have to record the Naruto news a little bit later. He sadly won't be on for the rest of the episode unless he comes on miraculously early. But, yeah, he doesn't usually show up until about 3 in the morning our time, so I don't see him all that often. He said he was going to try to be on, but I guess he's probably asleep right now, and he's not answering the text on his phone. Bad side, bad. Oh, also, make sure to keep an eye out on Gothic Zero Gara's page on YouTube, because the episodes will be posting up on there very shortly. Hopefully before Ichiban, I should have all the episodes posted up. We're going to record a day early for all the people going to ALA and Ichiban, because they happen at the same time. So nobody's pretty much going to be around on Friday, because our California people, most of them are going to ALA. And then myself and Eno, we're headed over to Ichiban. The cool thing is we've got the last episode of filler to talk about. And, well, not of all time, unfortunately. I'm pretty sure they'll do another set next year, and that's going to royally piss us all off yet again.
But dang, got my hopes up.
Right. I think part of the reason why they've been doing all this filler is because Studio Pierrot has been working on extra animation for the video game, and so they were like, oh, let's just do filler while we're working on the game. So Ninja Storm Generations better be fucking amazing, otherwise I'm going to be severely disappointed. I'm going to be like, look, you wasted our time with that much filler for this? Really? Really? So it better be epic. That's all I'm saying. So yeah, end of the year. I mean, we've done our opening and everything, but let's go ahead and let everybody introduce themselves. So,
yo, it's Kakuzu. How's it going?
Sasuke here, and I'm in charge of growing your brain cells.
Good luck with that.
Hi, I'm Ino. Sorry, I'm tired. And I'm drunk.
You're like yelling at you for a while. Oh, you're drunk! It's awesome.
No, not yet. I'm buzzed.
Same thing.
So,
hello, everybody. I'm Toby. I am the Lord of the Lobsters, the Master of Muffins, and the ruler and destroyer of all sanity.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, I think God. I just lost some brain cells.
We lost brain cells off of just his introduction alone.
Sasuke, do something intelligent, please.
And my job is now complete.
I'm Kakashi, and let my questions be your pleasure.
Oh, God.
No.
Hello, I'm Tamari. I'm the one who's always on Photoshop when I should be paying attention to the podcast.
Yeah, you and your damn dancing fleas.
Hey, I don't always draw fleas. I draw dragons, too. Mm.
I am Choji, and Tamari is here for fun.
What?
Tamari sent you a food plate?
No, she hit me with a fan.
Hit you with her fan. Oh, okay.
I'm Payne, and I just locked Toby in some random dungeon in Skyrim so I can go home and enjoy this goddamn pizza... fuck it. Shit.
Pizza fuck it shit. He just realized that Toby... As soon as he did all that, he realized that Toby had already gotten out, and he was like, fuck it, shit.
Why can't I eat this pumpkin pie in peace, goddammit?
Either that, or maybe he just walked outside and saw that Toby was sitting on top of the muffin that had crushed his van.
I can see my house from here.
You know what? Fuck it. I'm done with this shit.
God damn you, Toby.
Ah, pain. Looks like someone's being a grumpy monkey.
M. Doctor, I run the Ask Backwards Anime Podcast, Jessica and Tumble Podcast, one podcast for girls. I cannot be stopped, goddammit!
He is also the QB!
Kurama.
Oh, yeah. By the way, Doctor, we figured out your name this week. Yeah, apparently now you're also a Yu Yu Hakusho character on a Naruto podcast.
Hey, at least he's not Kuwabara.
Kurumishi!
Kurumishi!
Kurumishi! Can you make me a middle too, Kurumishi?
Oh, my God. All right, yeah, so for those that didn't know, we're working on trying to get Chris Sabat on the Fairy Tail podcast. Make sure to check that out. The Fairy Tail podcast is actually beating Konoha Corner, which is really funny because Konoha Corner has been around for almost 2 years now, and Fairy Tail's been on for 6 months, and it's kicking the shit out of Konoha Corner. So if you're wondering why we feel kind of lackluster about KC, that's why.
I had that same shit happen to me with Gintama.
Really?
It's been on less than a year.
It's like, you've got, like, insanely more listeners.
Yeah, so. It's strange.
It really is, because I didn't figure that Fairy Tail had as big of a fan base as Naruto does. Naruto should have a bigger fan base, and in fact, I think it still does. But it's crazy. Alright, that's our intro and everything. That's all the stuff we really got to talk about. I'm not talking really much podcast news this time around. Except to say that we are going to hold auditions eventually, but we're not holding any auditions right now for the High School of the Dead Abridged, but we are going to do auditions, and nobody is guaranteed a part. Even though we've got an idea as to who would be perfect for what part, we're going to, even on the crew, everybody has to audition. So, in case you've heard people sitting out there saying, hey, we are doing this, and this person's playing that person. No, that's not what's going on. Everybody has to audition for the role. Alrighty, so we are now going to move into the anime and Naruto news. Our first item up is Crunchyroll to stream Prince of Tennis 2 TV anime. I didn't even know they were making a second Prince of Tennis, but woot woot! The media service Crunchyroll announced on Friday that it will begin streaming the Prince of Tennis 2 television anime series on Wednesday, January 4th at 1:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The series will be available in North America, South America, Central America, Greenland, Ireland, Spain, Portugal, UK, Ireland, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand, Denmark, Finland, Netherlands, Norway, Sweden, and Turkey. Because, you know, those hungry people need something to eat and watch while they're eating turkey. Damn Hungarians! But, Takashi Konomi's original New Prince of Tennis manga has been running in Shueisha's Jump Square magazine since 2009. The story begins several months after the national tennis tournament that ended the original Prince of Tennis manga, Viz Media published the 42nd and final volume of Konami's original manga in North America in July. So that is for all of you Prince of Tennis fans out there, and I know there are quite a few, so I figured we'd talk about it. Now, Brave 10 Ninja Action Anime's 3D promo streamed. I don't know about the idea of going 3D, but the animation for this looked effing amazing. The official website for the anime adaptation of Kairi Shimotsuki's Brave 10 manga had began streaming the third 106-second promotional video on Thursday. The series will premiere on January 7th. Now, the most interesting thing I can bring from this is that during this trailer, there's no subs, but I heard somebody announce that they were Hattori Hanzo, and I was like, oh my god, Kill Bill reference. Oh my god. Now, I'm sure Hattori Hanzo was an actual person, but my mind flipped immediately to Kill Bill, and I was laughing so hard I could not actually finish the trailer. But the animation was amazing, and the action looked really intense and awesome. And every news article that we're doing on here, we're posting on the Konoha Corner page, so make sure to go and check those out at your earliest convenience. Yes. All right, so our next one actually is some good news from the voice actress world for once. Voice actress Yumiko Kobayashi gives birth to healthy girl.
Aww.
Kobayashi, who has played Sarah McDougal in Love Hina, Oyama in Angel Beats, and Mamoru in Sister Princess, announced on Thursday that she gave birth to a 2,161 gram, or about 4.79 pound, baby girl on Wednesday, December 28th. Despite the baby's small weight, both the mother and the baby are doing well. The estimated due date was not until January 20th, but Kobayashi joked that her baby decided, "I'm already done, I'm coming out now." Kobayashi acknowledged that she had not yet decided on the baby's name since the baby arrived early, so she nicknamed her baby Junior for now. There's a picture on here of her, and this is, I'm sorry, considering all the deaths that we've had to announce this year, this was something I felt kind of need to be announced, because, hey, it's about more life! So, positive news out of this, instead of like, oh, this voice actor dropped dead, or this voice actor dropped dead. There is positive news in the world, we swear to God! We're not the anime version of CNN. Next up is 2012's anime film lineup. And we're going to list through a set of films that are going to be coming out next year. So, January, Magic Treehouse. Yeah.
Sounds
gay as all hell.
Yeah, exactly. The Magic Treehouse. That's totally something I want to see. Tibetan Dog and Sacred Seven Shirogane no Tsubasa will begin on January 7th. January 21st will be Dot Hack Sekai no Mokuni Eiu Densetsu Sora no Kiseki. The animation will be coming out on January the 28th. February's list is Berserk Ogan Jidai Hen 1 Hao no Tamago, and that will be February 4th. Dragon Age Dawn of the Seeker, or Dragon Age Blood Mage no Seisen, that will be February the 11th. The March lineup is Doraemon, The Animal Adventure, March 3rd. Scryde Alteration 2 Quan, this is an event screening that will be taking place on March the 10th. Precure All-Stars New Aid, New Stage, Mirai no Tomodachi, or The Future Friend, will be coming out March 17th, along with Strike Witches on March 17th. April, we're looking at Space Battleship Yamato 2199, and that will be out on April 7th. Detective Conan, the 11th Striker, April 4th.
Oh, yeah.
Suddenly it seems like there's a relevancy as to why we brought Doctor on. Only a little. Crayon Shin-Chan.
Oh, God.
More Shin-Chan. A Shin-Chan movie coming
that is
out.
The best.
Let's
April
14th. They make that for Laura Bailey to read.
Yes. And Laura Bailey, I love how she describes doing Shin-Chan's voice. She says it's like having a potato in your throat. All right. A Letter to Momo will be April 21st. Then the spring lineup, because they haven't officially had an announcement for the month. Either that or May is apparently just called spring. Hana no Utame Gothic Maid, Kami Usagi Rope, those are the spring ones because they don't have a specific date registered yet. Kind of like summer, there's no specific date on some for the summer either, or early summer. June, Blood Sea, The Last Dark, comes out June the 2nd. So Blood Sea is getting a movie. Berserk Ogon Jidai Hen 2 will be out June the 23rd. Early summer, you're looking at Library War. That sounds amazing. We're going to kill each other with paper cuts.
Yay! Go, Tom Sawyer!
Yes!
Okay. Yay!
For July, we're looking at Okami Kodomo no Ame to Yuki. So, from what I'm looking at, Okami, Child of Rain and Snow.
God, that's what.
Gekijouban, Pocket Monster, Best Wishes, or Pokemon, Best Wishes. Kyurem versus Saikenshi, that'll be July 14th. So, just what we needed in the world of anime, another fucking Pokemon movie.
They're already up to 15 right now.
I know, it's sad. It's
not sad.
Balls yes, haven't dropped yet. These
more popular than anything else.
It's sad. Anyway, that's because there's always more kids being born.
I heard you like Mudkips, Gaara.
I do not like Mudkips, you asshole. That was a Gaara walking around with a troll face under his Gaara mask. That's what that was. Anyway, August, the only film slated for August, Fairy Tail, the movie, August 18th. The slated films for summer. I love this. Untitled Naruto film. This maybe is, again, TBA, to be announced. We've just heard that there's going to be one next year. We don't know when. The Life of Gusko Budori, Magical Girl, Lyrical Nanoha, the movie Second A's, The Fall Lineup, Rebuild of Evangelion 3.0, 009 RE Cyborg, so I'm guessing that's like a Cyborg 009 continuation of some sort.
Yeah,
Berserk Ogon Jidaihen 3, Korin, will be out in the fall. Okay, now, I love this next one. Sometime in 2012, Kizumonogatari, Resident Evil Damnation, the CG movie.
I thought that already came out.
No, that's not, no, there was a CG movie. That's Degeneration, not Damnation.
Okay.
Sakasama no Patema, and an untitled Blue Exorcist film. So sometime in 2012, there will be a Blue Exorcist movie.
Blue Exorcist, yes.
Sometime in 2012 or after, because this could be either or, Steins Gate, Simcarol 2, Taru Majutsu no Index, Puella Magi Madoka Magica. That's way too much magic in one phrase.
Yeah.
Marduk Scramble, the third part, Tiger and Bunny, which are two films, Niji Iro Hotaru, Gekijoban, Saint Seiya, and surprise, surprise on this one, Mass Effect.
Ooh.
Expected event screenings in 2012. Mobile Suit Gundam UC Parts 5 and 6.
Fuck yeah.
As well as Rurouni Kenshin Shin Kyotohen. And in 2013 or after, Space Pirate Captain Harlock. And that is your movie lineup so far. Again, there'll probably be more updates to this later. And we move on to our last piece, which is our New York Times bestseller list for December 18th through the 24th. So I just want to go ahead and say that FMA took over in the first spot. But moving on, One Piece Volume 59 came in 10th. The Drops of God Volume 2 hit 9th place. Dorohedoro, Volume 5, was in 8th. Marduk Scramble, Volume 3, and 7th. And Naoka Takeuchi's really hanging in there with Sailor Moon, Volume 2, in 6th place. It's been in there for a while. Maximum Ride, Volume 5. Tenjo Tenge, Full Contact Edition, Volume 4, took 4th place. Triple X Holic for Volume 18. And since we know that Full Metal Alchemist, Volume 27, took 1st, Masashi Kishimoto is really kicking some serious ass to be here 3 weeks in a row in the top 10 for Volume 53 of Naruto in second place. This is the third week in the top 10, so pretty good considering that One Piece and Sailor Moon are the only things that have been around for about that long. Sailor Moon Volume 2, this is its fourth week, and One Piece Volume 59 is in its second week, and it's already at number 10. It took 4 weeks for Sailor Moon to drop down to number 4, but 3 weeks in, and Naruto's still at second place with Volume 53, and for good reason. Volume 53 was, I would say, one of the best that has come out in recent times. So there we go. That is your weekly poll list that we're now doing, because we're crazy like that.
I watched a bit of the actual TV series.
What, the Don't Talk in the Library or whatever it
Library
was?
Library Wars, yeah.
Library Wars. What is it actually about? Can you explain?
If I remember correctly, it's kind of this, there is a privatized army involved in protecting written works in general. I think that some laws have passed where it's illegal to own various books and stuff.
Oh, okay. Alright, so once again, if you want to check out all the news items that we talked about, make sure you visit our Facebook page, facebook.com/KonohaCornerPodcast, and see all the news items that we posted on there, because we post each news article on our Facebook page now. That's our new thing. So that having been said, we are going to move on to fan mail.
Hey guys, so I kind of fucked up on some stuff, and have to re-record all of the fan mail on my own, because fan mail, Toby's Tales, Culture Corner, Japanese Word, all got deleted because, or just disappeared, got lost on my computer somehow. So fan mail's the only thing I'm able to re-record, and I'm doing that right now as I'm editing. And so you guys still get your fan mail, but unfortunately, Toby's Tales, Culture Corner, and JWoww for the end of the year, gone. And I'm not doing retakes of it, because that would be a pain in the butt, and it would take me at least... You'd be waiting at least another 4 days for the episode if we have to re-record, because scheduling's a nightmare, getting everybody together. My whole crew can't get on all together because they do other podcasts as well. So it's just really difficult. So I'm just going to go ahead and read out the fan mail for that episode. So I apologize to the rest of the crew who was actually on when we did this. All right, so first one comes from Asia Montreale Ashley, and she says, yeah. Then our Twinkie, Tiffany Trin, says, hi again, even though I sent fan mail, which she did. I'm just reading the comments on Facebook, guys, so... I'm sorry if I didn't read your fan mail. I am so sorry. Daniel Kaysen says, hey, Kona Hot Corner, it's me, Daniel, from the chat you had once. I just want to say, if it's possible to stop being so kick-ass, that would be appreciated. So far, I've gained plenty of anime-related brain cells and lost them all in the same episode. And at this rate, I will become a vegetable. I hope you guys keep going and getting up to 2 billion episodes. Okay, 2 billion? That's kind of stretching it. Sasori actually posting. She said, Sasso is watching. And we had to read this. This is just too funny. I also burned my finger today while wood burning. How ironic, Eggface laws. The puppet got to burn and Oro makes his evil return. That's right, Oro will be returning sometime soon. Sam Shui says, referring to the opening... Do you know that there's a musical about people who fight for the right to pee called Urinetown? Yeah, I don't know, but my school's putting it on this year. That's actually kind of crazy. Anyway, Safivum, nice to hear from you, Letter Pal. Christian Lewis posted, and this is actually what they're posting. I'm not, like, this isn't ego-stroking. Gaara's so flippin' awesome! So glad the fillers are over. Finally, we can get started on the Ninja War. Loves everyone. Special hearts for Naruto and Temari. Desmond Miles, which has got to be one of the greatest names I've ever seen on Facebook. Nice to see some assassins talking to the ninjas. I love fan mail! Grace Goldman, I have tried to send fan mail, but my email fails. I love you guys. All right, Courtney Davis, you guys are awesome! Love you guys. John Stockwell, Toby for rejecting my gift, this means war. And he continues with throws Pokeball at Toby with Orochimaru inside it, putting Toby in with Orochimaru. Connor Malloy says, Toby gets an ID card, and he will fill that motherfucker out. Who are you, damn it? And anyone else think the QB getting a name was awesome? P.S. Has anybody read Breaker or Breaker New Waves 3Bs for everyone, booze, bacon, and boobs? And yeah, that is going to wrap us up for fan mail, and we are going to move on to the manga recap. Okay, so yeah, I lied. It's not the manga recap. We're actually going to do the anime recap. Gotcha, bitches. Alright, so Sasuke, what the fuck happened this week?
Basically, it was the final filler for the year, thank God.
Right?
Yes, very much right. Basically, it was a warning from Yamato to everybody, saying that to be on the lookout for ninjas who can mimic chakra signals and actual physical appearances. So, of course, while Guy is barfing
epic
up...
Epic foreshadowing!
Guy is barfing up everything. Naruto runs all over the place looking for ramen. He finds ramen.
How Naruto-like?
Not Sai.
Natsu Sai, okay.
Not Sai! Basically, the last bit is Guy is standing on the rocks, shouting to Aruba and Yamato and Naruto, saying, "One of you is the imposter. One of you is the imposter."
You mean Aiba?
Whatever. And then we go to a flashback because Kakashi comes in flying on the back of one of Sai's eagles, and it comes to a flashback of when Little Lee and Little Kakashi first met each other.
Little guy. Aww.
Yeah, no Lee. Even though they look
all
like
this guy, Kakashi.
And basically what it is that there is one scene which I find quite hilarious. It's Little Guy up in a tree. Kakashi is trying to take a piss. And he says, "Kakashi, I challenge you." He looks down at Kakashi holding his penis and the tree breaks. The next scene is Guy opening his green jumpsuit, showing Kakashi what he has. Kakashi says, "You just got acorns."
It was so bad.
Wait.
Wait, is this still Toby's Tales? What's going on?
I haven't been watching it yet.
That was a filler episode, Doctor.
No, that was the actual anime, which actually does seem a lot like Toby's Tales.
Hey, did we see anyone from Guy's family or
no,
Guy's original
unfortunately,
sensei?
No.
Alright, so yeah, that's penis jokes. That was the anime this week.
Pretty much.
Alright, so yeah, that thumbs up or thumbs down for the people that watched it. Who watched it?
Pretty much just me. Oh, he did too.
Okay, Sasuke, thumbs up or thumbs down?
Thumbs up because it's finally the last one.
Jiraiya.
Thumbs up because penis joke is the end of the year joke.
Alright, so getting ready for next year's penis festival, I see. Awesome. So yeah, that's going to wrap us up for the manga recap, or anime recap, and we're going to move on to the manga recap now. This week's chapter is chapter 568. It's called The Four Tails, The Sage King of the Apes. A dangerous predicament. Because, you know, the Four Tails just basically fucking just threw the Eight Tails around like he was nothing. We're just witnessing a giant wrestling match between the tailed beasts. That's what's really going on.
Yay, Dragon Ball Z reference.
Yeah, alright, let's get a play-by-play analysis from Jiraiya!
Oh, I get to do these first couple pages or something?
You get to do a play-by-play of the Four Tails versus the Eight Tails. You just watch them fight the hell out of each other. Like,
okay,
if this were a wrestling match, how would you describe it?
Hold on, let me get to the page where he starts the raping.
That's page one.
As my big
giant
monkey.
Yeah, but didn't you skip like 12 pages? Because you had to have the morning peacock and the double...
No. Oh, you wouldn't do it for the whole chapter?
Dude, you have to skip like 5 pages just to get to the next scene you see them in.
Well, describe what we're seeing here. You're the description guy. You're the analysis guy.
Yeah, since we totally want Jiraiya to be the analysis guy on anything. Okay.
But there's no boobies involved.
Damn.
Why do you have to ruin his day?
Damn it. You know what? Hold on. Porn. Okay.
Jiraiya, call it your big, giant, red monkey.
He is a big, big, giant red monkey.
Do I even want to know?
No.
No, you don't.
Okay,
so actually, pretty much first page, you're getting the eight-tailed octopus thingy. Yeah.
Octopus,
yeah, whatever. Wasn't that
Octopussy.
A movie? Yeah, I was like, wasn't that a movie?
Octopussy.
So the big giant red monkey is going after the octopussy?
Yes. A look at my enormous monkey.
No, page one. Red monkey has octopussy on the ground. Okay, so play by play. Yeah. So pretty much first picture, he literally has one of Killer Bee's tentacles and is throwing him around like a rag doll. Which is funny considering by the picture, Killer Bee is retardedly gigantic compared to him. Like, at least 3 times the size of him. So I'm like, holy crap, this guy is stupidly strong. And while he's doing this, he's having the lovely ramen-flavored Naruto snack.
I'm going by there's a distance involved.
Wait, you're going by? When did this happen?
You can find it later on page 6. It does an aerial view. He is teeny.
Really?
That's what she said.
Just now.
Alright, so we'll go on to the dialogue real quick, and then we'll do the play. Continue on with play-by-play for the first page. So, Naruto, you have to say, whoa.
Wait, did you not do the chapter 568?
Yeah, I did all of that.
Okay. Whoa!
Crunch.
Ellipses! Motherfucker!
Jack Monkey!
Thanks for the comment.
And apparently the QB's awake now. Motherfucker, that hurt. Why'd you wake me up? Waking up always hurts. Alright, on to chapter 2. Let's go with our color commentary. Jiraiya.
Chapter 2?
Page 2. Whatever. We're way beyond chapter 2.
But page 2 is a manga picture. Page 3.
Yeah, that one.
There you go.
It's technically page 2.
Gaara have hard time counting issue.
Yeah, I've listened to Toby's tales since we started this.
That would be why. Okay, so next play-by-play. We're no longer talking about giant monkeys. We're talking about green spandex suits. Oh, but we're not going into a better direction.
And a giant slug.
We're getting there. So yes.
Why, thank you.
So we have giant slug basically chasing after these guys, expelling this giant fog of death. So, woo! Dead tree. And begin.
All right. And it's also another point that I'd like to say about this chapter is we start, we end the year pretty much Toby free.
Yay!
There is no Toby in this chapter.
There is a god!
All right, Payne, since you asked, yeah, you're Four Tails.
Okay, but that's Naruto.
That's right. We don't have a Rock Lee. All right, Guy Sensei.
I'll do Guy.
Yeah, hard.
Hell yeah.
God.
Hell yeah! Dude, green. Gotta love that shit.
We don't have... All right, Kakashi, you're Kakashi, just for a change of pace.
And Jiraiya's Guy.
Yeah, right?
Yes.
Last week it was so funny because Hinata was Guy and Sakura was Kakashi.
So yeah, we're gonna bro fist this up.
Yeah. We're gonna bro fist this up. Alright, we had the gender bender last week. It's time to bro fist. Let's get we want the hot bromance. Let's go for it.
Bad bromance. Exclamation point! Naruto! We must save him!
Not until I have your acorns.
Oh my god!
When I was a kid!
God damn it, stop bringing up the past!
Alright. Guy, we have to take care of these clowns first.
All right, let's try that again.
Where's the comma?
Commas are important. Okay.
Comma, llama, here's the drama. All
right. Guy, we have to take care of these clowns first.
Hold on. They're not actual clowns, okay? It's like, Guy, we have to take care of these clowns first.
Oh, yeah, they're not clowns.
You're not actually fighting clowns.
Wait.
Toby's not in this chapter!
Okay. Oh, God. Okay.
Toby opens the mask and it's really Ronald McDonald.
No!
Oh, God. Okay. Guy, we have to take care of these clowns first. He's not the only one in a tight spot.
That's what she said.
Oh, my God!
Yeah, not the only one in a tight spot, like your balls and those tight...
No. It's better because if he immediately goes to the next dialogue, he's not the only one in a tight spot, and then...
He's not the only one in a tight spot. They pinned us down.
You get it? You get it? What the fuck is wrong with all of you people? Come on!
Penis joke!
Okay.
Insert random dick and fart jokes here.
Dick.
I think Doctor would be better suited to that since he does run a Gintama podcast.
Apparently, yes.
And that's 90% of Gintama right there.
Yeah, there was an entire truck. There was an entire truck filled with dicks.
We're not even gonna get into the Neo Armstrong Cyclone Jet Armstrong cannon.
That's the least of your worries.
How can we make this not be a penis? Let's call it a cannon with two cannonballs beside it.
It's a rocket.
Then we'll put wings in a slide.
Why does this remind me of Ackman describing
okay,
a
what the fuck is happening here, Jiraiya?
What?
What's happening on the next page?
There are six large
hands everywhere!
Oh my god! Tentacle rape with fingers!
I've seen the pants, I don't know where this is going.
Dude, the hands are... The tentacles are behind them, and their butts are going right there first. I know exactly where this is going, and no one's
I'm sorry, I'm sorry. It's like Kakashi, a guy turned around and was like, oh hell no!
Dude, look at Guy, he's like, oh shit. No training there!
Okay, Guy, you have to say whoa.
Whoa!
And then we've got Crumble and Rumble and Grumble.
I told you, dead tree. Dude, I totally knew it. That tree was drawn there for a reason. Oh, yeah, and I get dialogue about it, too. The tree's disintegrated? A rotting gas!
Oh, I'm sorry, that was Naruto's fault.
Yeah.
Fart jokes, gosh. Yay! We got penis jokes
in
the anime.
Year. We're just going to have fun with this, and I'm not even going to bother editing the manga recap.
Okay.
So we have penis jokes in the anime, and we have fart jokes in the manga. Man, we're good.
Hey, we're deep. Deep. Just where she wants us.
Okay. I'm worried about my chakra levels.
Yeah, I would be if I were you, buddy.
Stop!
You're worse than us now, Gaara.
Sorry, I wasted it all on Naruto.
All right.
All over... Yeah.
All over Naruto.
Okay. Dibs. I'm worried about my...
Yay, Naruto! Kakashi just had a
Yay!
Okay. I'm worried about my chakra levels, but there's no other way. Shadow clone jutsu!
People have been waiting 567 episodes for this.
Okay. Guy, here's the plan. We focus on the enemies in front... and leave our backs for each other. One more thing. Don't touch my ass.
Damn.
Ass to ass.
You just defeated the purpose of that whole set of dialogue.
Any objections?
Yeah, one. I want to touch your ass.
It's like yes. Stop talking about my damn penis.
I'll talk about your acorns if I want to.
Well, dude, all I know is right after my dialogue, there's a close-up of our asses touching.
Oh, God.
And a thump.
It has a thump and then close up going, just like that.
All right.
Sorry.
What's up with the double... Oh, okay, it's two Kakashis holding the Chidori. I was like, wait, did he just pass his Chidori over to...
I get to say the line one more time.
Morning, yes. Peacock.
No, first it's lightning
peacock,
chain.
Peacock, yeah, I know.
Peacock.
Morning, Peacock.
All right, anyway.
Lightning chain.
Or you can call it Raiden. Or you can call it Raiden for short. Lightning Exchange.
Okay.
Either
Raiden.
One. Okay.
Hell no, I'm not the original. I like my translation. Morning Peacock!
Gotta take care of that in the morning.
All right.
Flaming Sperm, no jutsu.
Oh my god.
Wait, so
fire.
Dude, I'm sorry, that looks so badass. Just how he just chopped all the tentacle hands.
Mm-hmm.
That looks amazing. And then we've got the flaming sperm. So.
Yay! Guys!
Wow, they're right. Big squiggly lines with details.
Yeah.
Squiggly lines for everyone.
That's a lot of background detail. I gotta say, Kishimoto's assistants did really good this week.
The next wave's getting ready.
Same here.
Oh my god. I've got a boner. Same here.
There's so much gay jokes in this thing.
I like your morning peacock.
Same here.
Same here.
Oh, God. Next
can
line.
Only be fought morning by the gorilla. Morning gorilla.
Next
morning
line.
Gorilla.
We'll take care of this quick so we can support Naruto.
That's what she said! Oh, my God. This dialogue is awful.
Okay, which one of the tail pieces is this? I'm sorry to sound racist, but they all look the same in that form.
That
one. One with the giant hat.
He was the one that had the, that was, shit.
Eight tails? No.
Yeah, the sea tower.
That's five tails.
Five.
Okay.
Okay.
Recognize the hat.
All right, now we've got more. Now we've got more wrestling moves. Doctor, you want to do wrestling commentary here?
I didn't know I was able.
Just throw in some wrestling commentary.
By God, it's a slobber knocker.
We were just having a right rip snorter over here, and then this piker shows up, and it's good night, Irene. We get it. You're from Space Australia.
Butter, that'd go great with my Grand Slam.
My turn. I don't know. All right, time for you to go Gurk, Naruto.
Gurk.
Gurk.
Needed.
Like you're, like you're popping a squat. Come on.
Gurk.
There you go. I think this is actually the Eight Tails, so Choji, this is your dialogue.
I had some practice.
A whole 20 years of it.
Yep.
Hey, it's me! Okay! Let go of Naruto, you stupid monkey!
Goddamn dirty ape.
Goddamn dirty ape.
Well, there's more Eight Tails, though.
Mm. Oh, motherfucker!
Dude, you have like 2 pages worth of this, man.
Motherfucker!
Give him an Italian accent when you do it.
Oh, God. An Italian accent? Like,
make him Sean Connery!
Yeah!
Oh, his laptop is dead, that's why.
Yeah.
Make him Sean Connery.
No, I am not making him Sean Connery.
Dude, Sean Connery.
No. I want to make him sound like Ezio.
I was going to say Ezio.
Yeah.
Oh, Ezio. Yeah.
So we need to get Roger on. When the Templars murdered my family. Okay. Ninetales, I hear you lent your power to one of Naruto's... God damn it. I hear you lent your power. That's what it's starting to sound like.
Oh, yeah, man.
Ninetales, I hear you lent your power to one of Naruto's clones when he was fighting Madara. We wouldn't mind one bit if you lent us... If you lend us that power again right now, you bastard!
Ellipses.
Yeah.
I have to fart.
Okay, now
out
it's your turn.
Out of my mouth.
You know what? I think I should just do it in that crazy, creepy German accent. Fuck it. Ninetales, I hear you lent your power to one of Naruto's clones when he was fighting Madara. We wouldn't mind one bit if you lent that power to us again right now, you bastard. And I fucked up that second line.
Commas are important.
Right? We wouldn't mind one bit if you lent us that power again right now, you bastard.
Maybe.
And this is now Ninetales' dialogue.
Oh, I didn't even realize it was.
This is why I'm not editing. Just as a special end of the year bonus, I'm giving them the manga recap raw. Awesome.
They like it raw.
We know you do.
Hot dog.
Hot dog. Really?
I crashed my legs when you said that.
Don't worry, I'll be over there.
Oh my God, the way you laughed right there, Doctor, sounded like Shy Ronnie. Shirane. Boner alert.
Ronnie, motherfucker. Alright,
Hold on, I'll be your beat.
And this is what we deal with on a weekly basis, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Alright, so anyway, it doesn't matter. She's not in this page.
Yeah.
Okay, alright. I'm not like you, A-Tails. I won't wag my tails to the Jinchuriki as easily as you have.
So you don't care what happens to Naruto at all?
Damn,
selfish fucking bitch!
You have a lot of dialogue.
This is actually not me. Toby, this is moderate dialogue.
Yeah.
All the way to the word obey. And then, hold on, we gotta figure out who's doing what here. Jiraiya, you've got dialogue already. God, every guy here has dialogue already. Well, in that case...
Let me be the, first.
I have no dialogue.
I said all the guys. You don't count.
You want a dude.
Do you have a penis where most women have a vagina?
Yes.
Lies.
Yes.
Pictures. Picture, it didn't happen, bro. Alright, so... Toby, you're gonna have the... No, I can't give it to you. You'll be talking right after yourself.
That hasn't happened.
Jiraiya hasn't been on in a while. You get to be Hashirama Dono, first Hokage. Sasuke, you're the first Hokage's wife. Sasori, since you're back on, you're back to Kushina dialogue.
Oh, great. The last time I did it, I died.
Yeah.
Now you're still alive. This time.
Okay. What are the odds?
And QB dialogue at the bottom. Woo-woo, let's go.
Hold on, how do you say collada? Something energy, how do you call
it? Coalesced energy.
Coalesced?
Coalesced.
Coalesced.
Yeah, coalesced.
I have a hard time pronouncing those words.
I know, translators are so many.
Big words.
Well, I got to get into douchebag modera mode.
Douche mode, activate.
That's not going to take too long.
Oh my god.
Not long
That's
enough.
That's what she said.
So glad
and
I'm
someone opened
English.
A beer right after that, I told her.
No.
Opened a beer.
Was it me?
She said.
Alright,
go for it.
Ninetales, you are merely a momentary life, a temporary existence of colitis. Fuck!
Coalesced! It's not colitis!
Coleslaw!
No, it wasn't coleslaw. He tried to say coleslaw.
The energy of this coleslaw is massive.
I was going to say colon energy.
I ate it!
He's not ass energy.
You meanie!
That's better than how I described taking a poop the other day. I was like, it's like my intestines and pancreas are throwing up a demon.
I remember that.
Can I just say massive instead of that word?
Coalesced, dude.
No, coalesced is existence of...
It makes you sound smarter.
Coalesced.
This is Mara we're talking about.
It's Toby.
He doesn't dumb it down.
Toby likes dumb words.
Yeah, but this is moderate dialogue.
So he does big words.
Yeah.
Coalesced, right?
Yes, coalesced.
Okay, just need to say it a few times to be able to remember it.
I am so glad I'm not editing.
Now do I start over?
Yep.
Ninetales, you are a fucking hell, man.
You are fucking hell, man.
Come on. Come on, try again.
I am fucking hell, man.
Come on, try again.
I'm going to use the commas. Ninetales, you are merely a momentary life, a temporary existence of colonist energy.
Coalesced energy.
Colonist.
Fuck. Just say coalesced energy.
Coalesced?
Yeah.
Ninetales, you are merely a momentary life, a temporary existence of coalesced energy.
Yay!
Okay, this time you got coalesced and messed up existence, but we'll move on.
Okay.
Energy that once was a single ultimate form.
And ladies and gentlemen, that's usually the part where I piece two sets of dialogue together in the edits and make it sound good. So now you know, voice acting's not nearly as easy as everybody thinks it is.
An unstable force, lacking intelligence or sapience.
Sapience,
I could have figured that.
Sapience.
An unstable force, lacking in intelligence or sapience. You require a guide to show you your purpose. That guide is the Uchiha. The tailed beasts are but slaves of those blessed with eyes. Obey.
All right. So, do we really want to provide commentary on the flashback here? Almost.
You don't need commentary. Let's just go.
That's a huge bitch.
Okay, that was the commentary. Moving on.
There you go.
Of course, now I'm changing my.
Oh my God! It's Princess Leia.
Yay! It's 10-10!
With red hair. It's a 10-10 fire crotch.
Woo! It's her mom that we never see!
You know what? I'd still hit that.
It's her mom that we never see.
So what? 10-10 and Naruto are related?
Yep.
No.
More screen time.
Well, in a way.
Never oh my god, shut up.
It all happened that one night at the bar.
Oh my god, let Jiraiya do his dialogue.
It's only two sentences. Ninetales, your power is too great.
Ninetales, comma, your power is too great.
Damn! Fucking commas!
There's a comma.
Ah, enlarge my screen. That is what she said. Okay, now I can see the comma.
You need an enlargement of how tiny it is.
Oh, God. Oh,
stupid acorn! Damn it, acorns! Ninetales. God. Sorry. Yeah. That was awful. Do I think there's puberty here? Well, that's why he's bleeding everywhere. It's... Yeah, right.
Okay.
Ninetales, your power is too great. I cannot let you roam free any longer.
Sex joke coming up. If you use your power, only hatred will come of it. Stay tranquil, deep inside of me.
Inside. I haven't heard that inside joke since the last time Jiraiya was on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry.
Mommy dialogue.
Great.
Mama, you're back!
Mama!
Mom, Lewis.
Lewis, vile woman.
Okay, can I go now?
Go, Mama.
Neither of us have any sort of luck, do we? You keep the world at bay, but I keep you at bay.
No matter how they say it. Human.
Ugh. Cubans?
Humans.
Tastes
so nasty.
Humans. Oh, I'm almost going to my Nori Wakamoto for some reason.
Yeah, normal ketchup just can never cover the taste.
Yeah. Humans always say one thing.
Sex. God damn it.
Stop me, right?
No, titties.
yum.
All right, yeah, it's still you.
A brat next? Those damn shinobi. In the end, even this one.
Hey, Ninetales, I want to take away that hate inside of you someday.
Oh, yeah, you do.
Oh, yeah.
And now you want to do that second word bubble correctly.
Yeah. Want to take away that hate inside of you someday.
One more.
Naruto has to crap.
Yeah.
Crap!
Oh.
And now we boob back. Now we move back to commentary again.
Oh, boob.
Boob. Yes, we boob back to commentary. So, Jiraiya, what's going on page 10?
Bad things for Naruto.
Bleeding oxes.
Oh, we're going to switch over to page 10?
Yeah, page 10.
Okay, well, basically we're getting a...
Yum.
A spurt from Killer Bee over here. By blood, I swear. It's not what you think it is.
It's not white enough.
No, it's not.
And then we go inside. Then we go inside the mind, and look what's happening.
All I gotta say is
S&M!
Is Monkey's cage has nothing on QB's cage.
Right.
I mean, I'm not sure, but I'm quite positive that there is something sticking out of his stomach.
Sorry
and it's
about
pointy.
That.
Every rose has its thorn.
Nope, that's not my chakra rod then.
Yeah.
Naruto. Split, motherfucker! And then the Ninetales mode wears off, and he looks up and he's inside a big giant space with a tied up monkey. Naruto, what are you doing with that tied up monkey? That's wrong. That is illegal in all countries.
Don't you know the song "Spank the Monkey"?
Oh God! Okay.
Hey, I wrote that a long
Sometimes
time ago.
You gotta shock the monkey.
I gotta try.
Let's go! I don't want to do this all day.
Yes,
okay. Can I try a new voice for this one?
Yeah, fine.
Okay. Oh, dude. God damn, I can't do that voice.
What did you think of Payne's horrible voice? Send your comments to GonaHotCornerPodcast@gmail.com or you can hit us up on Facebook, facebook.com/GonaHotCornerPodcast.
God, I can't do that voice. Okay, what kind of voice
I
is that?
You want to do
well, he is a monkey. He is
no, don't. Come on, guys.
You sound like a Riri.
He's
a smart monkey. Make him sound like Mojo Jojo.
Yes.
Let me
see my power for my next
day. I take it you want to steal my power for me next day.
Yeah, I did that. Oh, God.
This is going to be reason.
Take it. You want to steal my power from me next, eh? Okay.
If I haven't stopped, you keep going.
Barging in here of all places? You dirty little brat. Oh, ha.
You sound like Hulk Hogan.
Okay. Anyway, moving on.
Well, let me take some brother.
He looks like him. He has the handlebars.
Actually, yeah, it is.
The handlebar mustache, yeah.
What the... What are you?
No, he says, wait.
Wait, sorry.
The Four Tails?
Sorry. Wait.
Are you the Four Tails?
No, shit, Sherlock. Okay.
No. Remember, he's supposed to sound like English. Like
Asian. Don't call me that!
Don't call me by that wretched name! Okay. Don't call me by that wretched name! What the fuck?
Moniker.
Moniker.
Yo, it's a word. Come on.
Fuck you.
Don't call me by that wretched moniker. I have a proper honorable name.
Okay, do that again and again.
I love this. More English. Good.
I have a proper honorable name. Okay.
So like if you were a Japanese guy trying to speak English. Sound like that.
I have a God fucking hell.
No, you don't have a God fucking hell.
Just a little bit more racist, please.
Throw some racism on that.
$5 foot long. Okay.
Football.
Did you just say $5 foot long?
$5 foot long. Okay.
Hey, Naruto. Macarena.
I heard fart.
I just farted.
Okay. All right, come on. I have a proper honorable name. Let's get to it.
I have a proper honorable name.
Okay, yeah.
I am son.
Okay.
I am son of the ape.
Oh, no, he sounds gay.
You damn dirty ape.
I am son. Beautiful ape of...
What's that?
Beautiful ape, king of Suirin.
Okay.
I am son. Beautiful ape of king...
God, shit, I can't...
You're doing...
Of...
Dude, I give props to pain. This is cool.
I am son.
No
beautiful ape king. Listen. I am son, comma, beautiful ape king of Suirin Caves.
Oh, okay.
Brother.
And this is how we work in direct, ladies and gentlemen.
I am son, beautiful ape king of Suirin Caves. I am the sage king of the
fucking hell.
How did you fuck up apes?
I don't know. Sasuke.
Trust me, I have that on video and it's not pretty.
Oh my god.
Wait, you have a video of you fucking an ape?
No, you.
What? Oh my god.
How good was I? Okay.
Move on.
I'm the sage.
God
fucking. I'm the sage king of the apes. My name bestowed upon me by the sage of Sixpence himself. You address his holiness of all heavens, Son Goku! Ho ha ha!
I love this.
And this is where the Dragon Ball Z reference comes into play.
Nah, it's not a Dragon Ball Z reference. It's a Journey to the West reference.
Yeah, close enough.
No, Journey to the West was there centuries
before that.
DBZ made that.
DBZ imitated Journey of the West in that respect.
And Sayuki.
Well, Sayuki's more closely related to Journey of the West. Anyway.
I'm gonna go now.
Huh?
Okay. Huh? What? Wait, which part was your name? Oh, ha ha.
Son Goku, you slack-jawed idiot.
This is where the Mojo Jojo really comes into play.
Okay.
Humans are all stupid. You can't even remember names properly. You are all dumber than apes. And I should know, I'm an ape.
The more he keeps going, the more he starts sounding like the ninja from Ask a Ninja.
He does! Yes.
You look at the bottom left page. It's Ask a Ninja.
I will lend you my... God, fuck.
I won't lend you my godly fuck.
Acorns.
I won't lend you my power to such idiotic.
Wait, where am I? This is just like the Ninetales cage.
Are you even listening to me? You ignore my most honorable name and then don't listen to me at all? You are one rude...
Oh god.
One rude brat.
Okay.
You're one rude brat. You know that?
Huh? Well, I'm sorry.
Ninja stare. You are one honest human.
God, fucking hell. Okay.
You're an honest one, for a human at least.
You.
God, I'm trying to make it sound Asian, but there's so much American style
just,
in it.
Just imagine the Asian dude from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Oh, yeah.
Ninja Vanish.
Tatsu,
there you go.
Yeah.
You. You're an honest one. For a human, at least.
I ain't never... God, now I'm starting to sound like Killer Bee.
Oh, he's Southern?
I ain't never seen a human apologize to a tailed beast before.
Okay. Sorry, I had to say Killer Bee.
I ain't never seen a human apologize to a tailed beast before. So you're not in here to steal my power?
Actually, the word not was in bold for a reason.
Okay.
Dork.
Okay. So you're not in here to steal my power.
Oh, God, yes. Look at the next word that's in bold.
Yay!
I think we need to have Toby take over this dialogue part.
No, no, no. You've got one of us inside you.
No, no. You've got to say you've got one of us. Toby, you say inside, and then he says you. Okay?
What?
Are you on the page with us?
Yeah.
All right. Look at his next dialogue. What's it say?
You've got one of us inside you?
Uh-huh. He's going to say, you've got one of us. And then you're going to go, inside. And then he's going to say you and continue on.
Okay, I'm doing that.
Okay, let's go.
You've got one of us.
Inside.
You.
Greatest ever. This is the best New Year's gift we could possibly give the fans.
Okay.
Okay, so that's how you get... No, this is going to be the best part. Because what I'm going to have you say, Toby, are you listening? Toby,
yeah.
Are you listening? So... So he's going to...
Teriah's having a ball over there.
Acorns. So anyway, what he's going to say is, so that's how you could come, and then you say, inside, and then he says, here. Ready? Go!
So that's how you can come.
No, you could! Could! Not can!
That's how you come in.
You were so worried about coming, you forgot how.
I farted because it was so funny.
That was a fart. That's funny.
Okay, anyway.
So that's how you could come.
Inside.
Here.
All right, moving on. Next dialogue.
So much inside.
It appears that Karama trains his Jinchuriki well.
Wait a second. I don't see a redhead around here at all. Except for the monkey, but he's not talking about himself. What the fuck, Yoshihiro Togashi? Stay the fuck out of my Naruto!
Hey, if Black Chad could make it in, come on.
Well, that's true. Yu Yu Hakusho is a lot better than Bleach. That's a plus.
True that.
Alright. Naruto lines.
Hold on, I'm texting. Okay. Oh, M-A-T.
Texting doesn't involve your mouth.
R-E-S-S.
Apparently it does.
Okay.
Wait, did you just spell mattress?
Yeah.
It's not that hard of a word.
I know, but apparently autocorrect doesn't like it.
M-I-C-K-E-Y.
It must be like to pee on you.
My computer's making weird sounds at me now.
Okay, I'll go.
Does it sound like this? Oh!
No, but it's definitely groaning.
Sorry.
Well, it's right. You just screwed the QB then, because that's what I named it.
My computer's
name
pages.
Is QB.
Alright, yeah, we still got five pages. Let's move on.
Alright, I go. Wait, Kurama?
You fool! You're the Ninetales security.
God fucking hell.
Security? He just stands at the gate and is like, come on, you can't come in.
Hey, guys.
Don't make me get the chains.
You fool! You're the Nine-Tailed Jinchuriki, but you don't even know his true name? Humans, fools, the lot of you.
Wait a minute, the Nine-Tails has a name all along? So he's called Kurama.
I like how this is apparently amusing to Naruto or something.
It is.
Now I just need to find Hachibi's name.
You humans,
okay.
Let me try to cover it up with a whistle.
Humans!
You humans only view us as sources of power.
so you don't know our names and see no reason to learn. You seal us away and deny us our existence.
More da-da-dots. Sad da-da-dots.
Depressing flashback, no jutsu.
And I don't know, I don't care if I made you cry.
Mommy and Daddy.
Button. We need... Wait, what? No, no square? What?
We need a mommy and daddy.
I'll be the daddy.
No, I want my BBY to be daddy so I can hit him.
Okay.
Okay. Randomly. Any, mini, money, mode. Toby, you're the dad.
No, I want it. No!
And that's where her brain cells came from.
Damn it.
And the mommy is Tamari.
Oh, God.
Where's she?
And the child. And the child.
Don't do it.
And the child.
Don't do it.
It's the story.
Okay, we're good.
So wait, which of these lines are mine? Because it doesn't say.
Who's that, Daddy?
Mommy is, look, it's that child.
And you don't need to know, dear, probably.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Look.
Oh, it says, who's that, Daddy? You don't need to know, dear, that'd be the dad.
Yeah. Alright, anyway, moving on.
Look, it's that child.
Who is that, Daddy?
Don't get involved, just walk past him. Don't need to know, dear.
No, it's like, you don't need to know, dear.
You don't need to know, dear.
And then toss the fucking ramen at the bitch.
That damn brat!
Take that! I think I understand where you're coming from a little. I was just a moron back then. Just so people would scold me.
Huh? And moving on.
Toby! Ha! He's in there. One page.
God damn it!
2 pages!
We can't get away!
And just when you thought this episode was Toby-free.
I don't know, I thought there was an insult.
You know what, this
now.
Is gonna rhyme. Just when you thought this chapter was Toby-free, you get to the panel with Naruto standing in a big puddle of pee.
Funny.
I am, yes indeed.
That's why there's water everywhere. It's their pee.
Monkeys are standing. You're standing in the toilet.
They're chained down.
I swam in that shin.
They're chained down. How do you think they go to the bathroom?
It just leaks everywhere.
It just leaks.
At least it's not brown.
The diarrhea.
Yet.
If it's brown, it's really bad.
Naruto, go.
I'm
you
going.
Into first, and you feel something burst.
All right, I'm done. Diarrhea. Okay. It did not matter.
Stop trying to do his dialogue.
But it said that, like, it did not. Okay. It didn't matter how I did it, as long as I had people's attention. It was so much better than losing myself and disappearing from the world. I'm a Riri.
You're a wiener.
No, she's a Riri. She got it right.
It rhymes with Jinchuriki.
Oh my god.
I'm a Jinchuriki. Okay.
Back to dialogue.
Okay. I'm a Jinchuriki, but I've got a name. That's my parents and my...
Try that dialogue again. She just snorted.
I did. I'm congested.
It doesn't matter. It's still funny.
Okay. But I've got a name. No, they didn't. They didn't give me a name. Okay. But I've got a name that my parents and my master left me. It's Naruto.
That's Riri. Can't say her name.
It's Riri.
It's Naruto. It's Naruto.
It's Uzumaki.
It's Naruto, bitches.
It's David Bowie.
It's David Bowie.
I met a cat. His name was Bowie.
Oh my
it's
god.
It's Dan Green.
Can I say my name now?
Real name, no gimmicks.
Let me say my name, bitches.
I met a cat that name was Bowie, then he met his end with a knife.
Okay, anyway.
It's terrible. Naruto.
It's David Bowie. Okay. It's Naruto.
Not David Bowie.
Not David Bowie. I'm nobody.
No.
Oh, that's the winner.
That's Toby.
Well, that's your two.
I'm nobody, too.
So, I'm David Bowie.
Hey, no, hold on. Hey, Jiraiya. This one's for you, buddy. It's Toby-Toe.
Toby-Toe!
I don't even know if he's there. Jiraiya didn't respond.
I went to pee.
Probably.
Okay, go, Tobes.
Go, Toby-Toe.
I'm nobody. I don't want to be anybody. My only wish is the completion of the Moon's Eye Plan.
Is it me, or does he sound like the Dark Knight?
Slurring me.
I didn't do that last part. I messed it up.
Yeah, let's do it again.
I like it, Messi.
Go, Toby-Toe.
My only wish is the completion of the Moon Eye Plan.
Panties.
And stocking.
That's why.
Wait, there's Toby dialogue.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah. I had to say that's why first.
You did. Now it's Toby dialogue.
Yeah, I know.
Go, Toby-Toe.
A world with only despair in it has no right to exist at all.
I can't stand the thought of you guys fucking up this line, so I'll say it instead. Okay. I can't stand the thought that you guys are being... Okay. I can't stand the thought that you guys are being controlled by someone like him, who doesn't even care who he is.
Naruto, are you having too much fun talking to my giant monkey?
Yay.
Oh my god, anyway, moving on.
Yeah, the monkey's in a barrel!
Then, what would you do with us?
I want to be like B in the A-Tails.
Huh?
They joke around, have fights, encourage each other. I can't express it well, but I can see it from up close. It's like they're friends. And whenever I see that, I always think... It really hurts my bowels, but I try. I'm just so incredibly constipated. Okay. I'm just so incredibly jealous.
And that is perfect placement.
Pain.
For the monkey.
I'm jealous of your pain.
No, he's looking at the monkey and says, I'm just so incredibly jealous.
He's looking at his penis.
A human like you wanted to be friends with a tailed beast? You're a funny boy.
Da da da.
Kind of ran out of steam there, huh?
It's killing me. This Brett. He's actually serious.
Fuck yeah.
Time for sushi.
I'm still not saying anything.
Okay. So I want to help you, too. What was your name again?
Just call me Sun. And I ate you out there. Why do you taste like ramen? And what you gonna do about that? I can't just crap you out.
Crap! I forgot about that for a second.
It's a damn sight better than a masked one, idiot.
Ooh, pretty picture.
Shouldn't talk about your master like that.
Are you gonna finish the dialogue?
I did.
No, you didn't.
No. Did I skip a page?
Yeah, skipped the last two panels of the entire chapter, idiot.
Okay. There's a way to... Oh, God, fucking hell. There's a way to fuck me?
No.
Oh, damn.
No! No monkey sex.
That's how AIDS is spread.
But yes. But that's where humans learned it from.
Oh my god. No. Don't you know the song? You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it like they do on the Discovery Channel.
And yeah, that's also
where
kind
humans
of,
learned it.
And that's
there's
also
always
kind of
been the Discovery Channel.
Where would I be without that channel?
No Mythbusters.
Be in Africa, that's for sure.
Yeah, I'd be sad.
You know what? Before they had Playboy, poor little boys had to wank it to freaking National Geographic. Shut up.
Sure that.
For those days, Gara?
No.
Oh,
I don't
that African. Those neckties.
Okay, I'm going to just do my dialogue. I'm going to just do my dialogue now.
There's a way to stop me. You might be able to convince me if you undo these chains for me.
Ha ha, son!
That sounds really creepy.
I love that.
A reliable ally? chapter 568. End. Okay, now it's time to, God, stare at the ugly face. Ah, ah, this is really good manga color, though. Ah, then we get to the Kages. Ah, the Kages are gonna kill me!
Giant balls of death.
Bitch, I want my eye back.
I'm allergic to Toby! Ah!
Oh my god! Where's Bruce Willis?
So, Jiraiya, we changed the name. We've decided it's Tobito.
I thought it was Tobu.
Instead of Toby and Obito, we just call it Tobito.
They haven't fused yet, though.
You don't know that.
Yeah, we do.
Tobito. We like Tobito. It's easy to say. All right, so, yeah, we're going to go ahead and go around the call and see what everybody thought of this chapter. So, thumbs up or thumbs down, Kakashi?
Up.
Naruto?
Up.
Kakuzu?
Up.
Lisanna? Or Tamari?
Wait. Thumbs up.
Sasori?
Thumbs up.
Sasuke.
Thumbs up.
Pain.
Two thumbs up.
Jiraiya.
Thumbs up.
And Toby.
Thumbs up.
And Doctor.
And me.
And you.
Thumbs up.
Okay. So what's one thing you liked or didn't like about this chapter? I mean, it is the final chapter of the year, so let's give it some gusto. Kakashi.
I like the way that Kakashi cut all the hands.
Naruto.
I like the... Butterbeer.
I will be over there soon.
Okay, ADD. Sorry. Up and think about the manga.
Sorry, such goodness. Okay, anyway. I forgot what we read.
You knocked the hell out
of that. Okay. I liked the.
You just had a dialogue between the four tails and Naruto, and you forgot all of that?
Yeah, kinda.
Moron.
I like the butt sex.
What's butt sex?
I think she loved it when Guy and
they literally had butt sex. Both of their butts touched. They did it.
It's not sex, Naruto.
It is now.
It's
ass to ass, okay?
It's ass to ass.
No, it's ass tech.
They farted so hard that they actually flew in opposite directions.
Yeah, it's Naruto. It's ass tech.
Naruto. No.
What?
I'm gonna have to take you for some special training. I'll be over there in a minute.
Oh, good God.
Does it take care
of I'll watch.
Kakuzu.
In a minute.
I like that we find out that QB actually has a name.
Okay. Tamari.
Oh god. I have to pick a favorite part? Oh yes. Shit. Actually, there was the one panel, which was like the flashback of, when Naruto was saying he was gonna get rid of QB's hate, and it cut to QB's expression. And I was like, oh my god.
Sasori.
I like how Mami Kushina got some more dialogue.
Sasuke.
I'm with Naruto. I like how we finally know the names of at least two of the tailed beasts.
Pain.
I really enjoyed seeing the whole conversation between the four tails and Naruto. It's kind of interesting.
Jiraiya.
I like King Oral Monkey. Dude, his mouth is a giant hole. That's it.
Toby.
I just like the fact that all the tailed beasts are actually getting some character development. I'm hoping that the others get the same development too. Wouldn't it be cool for each of them to have a different personality and such?
Yeah, I think they all have one though. And finally, Doctor.
I like the Kurama reveal. I think that's kind of cool.
Okay. Alright, so what are your predictions for the next chapter? Because I think we're getting one next week. Kakashi.
Monkey will be set free and let loose on the land, and Godzilla will reign again.
But Godzilla wasn't a monkey. Don't you mean King Kong?
No, the monkey will go fight Godzilla, and then Godzilla will kill the monkey, and he will reign again.
Okay, Naruto.
I agree.
Kakuzu.
I think Naruto's going to be passed around by each tail beast to be set free.
I like the idea that Naruto's gonna get passed around by the tailed beast.
Hey, he's the community Jinchuriki.
Oh god.
You're such a whore, Naruto.
Yeah.
The neighborhood bicycle.
My bad.
The neighborhood bicycle. Everyone gets a ride. Damari!
I'm going to have to agree with Kakashi on this one.
Sasori!
Really? Everybody's taken all of them.
Make shit up.
Pretty much everybody's just been agreeing with Kakashi with that the
I got a different idea.
Beat up Godzilla.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
God. Sasuke.
I'm looking forward to finding out all the beasts' names.
Pain.
I think Naruto's going to catch them all and pwn.
Stop Pokemon!
Gotta catch them all.
Pwn the hell out of Madara. Because he's going to absorb all the powers of the Tail Beast.
It's not
what would happen if Naruto became like the new Ten Tails?
Yeah.
Mikey Ten Tails. Alright. Jiraiya.
I think Black Chad's going to appear and kick everyone's ass. You know why? Because he's fucking Black Chad.
Alright. Toby.
What I believe is that Naruto's going to figure out that the chains that binds Goku is actually the same technique that his mother has. So he'll probably have the ability to break the chains. Therefore, I believe that Goku is going to help Naruto basically take down all the other beasts. He's going to Goku's going to hold them down, and then Naruto's going to jump down their throats and try to convince them and break the chains. But as for the whole Naruto becoming the new Ten Tails, that probably is not likely going to happen considering One Tails isn't there. Because Gaara's still alive, there's no host for Tobi to put Shikaku in. So it's kind of sad that Shikaku's not going to make an appearance in this battle. But I have a feeling that Naruto's going to find a way
unless he put them so.
You know, it's going to figure out a way to get past all this tailed beast stuff, but I have a feeling that Tobi has backed up enough chakra and that Gendo statue to still be able to continue his plan.
Okay. And finally, Doctor.
Okay, so Tatsu's actually going to run the foot, but it's going to be revealed that the Shredder is still alive and he's going to come in and actually, you know, rule the place all over again.
You know what? I think a little too Wrath is going to be the state of affairs.
A little too Wrath, yeah.
Like, dude, where's the pizza?
The new Turbo Gensu!
Should have brought bagels.
We gotta free our uncle, the
Sony. Wait, he's Jewish?
No.
He said should have brought the bagels.
And what did you guys think of this recap, finally? Kakashi.
Fun.
Naruto.
Four words. I like it raw.
Uh-huh, I'm sure you do.
I will be there in 5 minutes.
Kakazu.
Pretty good for what I could hear when I wasn't lagged.
Tamari.
Derp. Nuff said.
Sasori.
Ass-tastic.
Pain.
The fact that I gotta try out a brand new voice.
You got to be Mojo Jojo. Mojo Jojo! Jiraiya.
So many acorns. They're everywhere.
If you pile them up together, they could equal one Kakashi.
Trust me, I've seen it. They're bigger.
All right, just for that, when you're doing a raw, poke her in the spleen for me. Thanks, appreciate it.
Okay. I'm good.
Toby.
It was really fun. Though I didn't like how everyone was rejoicing that Toby wasn't in it.
What?
But he was in it.
It made me feel sad.
Yeah, Toby, you were in it, unfortunately.
Yes, but everyone was rejoicing when they thought that Toby wasn't in it. It made me sad.
Not you, Toby. Oh, that's right. We've decided you're no longer the evil Toby. You have to do the derpy Toby dialogue with Toby now. And finally, Doctor.
I actually really enjoyed it. It was kind of fun. I think the fact that it was like going from... What was it? I think it was like Mojo Jojo to Hulk Hogan to Tatsu to some weird mix in between of there.
Right? I was just waiting for, honestly, I was just waiting for Macho Man Randy Savage to make
Oh, it Macho Man Randy Savage!
He's dead, too!
Yeah.
Snap into a Slim Jim!
That's what it looks like! It looks like two Slim Jims coming out of his mouth.
Oh, then I'd be eating that.
Super Ninja Beanie Treat!
Oh, yeah!
Super Ninja Beanie Treat!
So, yeah, that's going to wrap us up with the manga recap and pretty much this episode of the podcast. And all that's left for us to do is just try to name this fucked up episode. So, episode 132 should be called what, Kakashi?
Push your breath together and say cheese.
Oh, God. Naruto.
Raw acorns.
Kakazu.
Monkeys, acorns, and Happy New Year.
Happy New Raw Acorn.
Happy ending?
You want happy endings? Tamari.
Monkey butter.
Bacha can.
Oh my god.
Oh god. It's probably
Sasori.
Raw acorns and butt sex.
Oh really? I thought it would be I burnt myself today.
Nah.
To see if I could feel. Sasuke.
Happy New Year and ape acorns.
They're not that tiny.
Oh, hey, Pain.
Jiraiya finds his acorns and Pain gets his mojo back.
Jiraiya.
Big monkey Slim Jims and little Naruto acorns.
Toby.
Inside the monkey are small acorns.
Oh. Inside.
Oh. Inside. Doctor.
Got it.
Next semester, we rebuild the foot.
Next semester, we rebuild the foot. Yes, I like that. Alright, and mine is episode 132, Kishi Likes It Raw. That's the worst part about going last. Most of the shit I had that was good was stolen. So. I like that. Next semester, we rebuild the foot. Alright, yeah, so that is it for us, and we are going to play through all the ways that you can contact us.
Be sure to check us out on iTunes and the feed, and be on the lookout for any special episodes like Yaoi Corner and Pervy Place. Also be on the lookout soon for our outtakes, which we hope to post as two albums on iTunes, as well as our parodies.
Remember to stop by and check out our website to listen or to watch our latest episodes. Remember to check out the podcast section for our link to our Mega Upload account, where we have posted our first 50 episodes. Also, make sure to post on our forums, as you may ask any questions of the staff that don't operate on Facebook. Be sure to send me some bacon, as I love it very, very, very much. If you join, I shall send you a free painting of the TARDIS and a lifetime supply of bacon.
You can check us out on Facebook, where we will keep you updated whenever a new episode is posted up on the feed. You can also check our discussion boards, where we will have a variety of subjects for you to discuss with the crew of Konoha Corner.
Or our event pages, which has been updated whenever we are scheduled to do a panel. You can also check out and comment on our photos from cons, pics made for our podcast, and pics that fans have posted on our wall. So look up Konoha Corner on Facebook, and remember, beware of imposters.
And if you would like to join us on DeviantArt, you can visit konohacorner.deviantart.com, where we have the largest Naruto gallery on DA, as well as a huge community of artists. You can participate in our contests, as well as find Enria 2002 and Yami no Kuni, who do our logos. You can also join our group of manga fans who put together fan art for the weekly manga chapters to be shown on our YouTube videos.
Also, Sai runs our DeviantArt page, so please, if you are trying to join as Jonin or Chunin, you have to get with Sai. He will send you a note if you are trying to apply for the position. You have 24 hours to get back in touch with him, as he will let you know the terms and conditions of becoming a Jonin or Chunin. If you feel you're up to the task, please note him back immediately, and we will add you as Jonin and Chunin. Also, make sure when you join, post up your images in the podcast submissions folder if you wish to join our fan art contest. One staff member each week will pick their top 20 that will go into a voting folder by the staff. They'll pick their top 10, and the entire community votes on the top 5. Those top 5 winners, their image is discussed on the podcast and invited to the episode to discuss their image. So make sure, if you would like to have your image discussed on the podcast, to submit any pictures that you want in the podcast fan art submissions folder.
Be sure to follow us on Twitter, as all of our updates from our Facebook page are up on Twitter immediately as they are posted on Facebook. You can use your phone to keep current with all things Konoha Corner. And remember, for every follower we get on Twitter, Toby donates a muffin to Kishimoto.
Now remember, next week we have Ichiban Con and ALA that we're going to. Konoha Corner is not officially going to ALA, but it's pretty much the same. So if you guys don't mind, I was talking to some people today that were asking me, you know, what's going on with the feed, why are there three feeds, how much do they cost, and it's $75 for the new feed for Konoha Corner, in order to have so much space that we can put up 22 episodes a month. It's expensive. Fairy Tail's about $50, and then I've got $25 for the old Konoha Corner feed. It's pretty fucking ridiculous. It's about $150 a month. So please, guys, if you would donate to us, we would really, really appreciate it. Even if it's only like $1 or $2, man, it'd really, really help us out. And it's really simple. Just go to KonohaCornerPodcast.webs.com, click on the donate button, and you can donate directly to the Konoha Corner bank account, or you can donate to us on PayPal by typing in KonohaCornerPodcast@gmail.com in the section for who to donate to and gift us that amount of money. And we really, really appreciate it, guys. It helps us get to all the conventions and get all the stuff that we need to do, plus keep the feed running and everything. I mean, we can't just keep asking Kakazu over and over and over to empty his bank account. Eventually, the man does have to pay expenses for Katsuki. So, you know, the Batcave ain't cheap. Just saying.
Especially the new Toby tax.
Oh, God. Yeah, considering the amount of damage Toby does, Kakazu's more than already. So, yeah.
Can I go strangle him now?
Yes, please, go for it. Anyway.
Yay.
Alright, but while you're doing that, please don't forget the reason that we're all here. I actually now have volume, box set 9 of Naruto. You should too. Help keep Kishimoto employed, and it's really easy to just do the same things I did. Pick box sets, man. Purchase the anime, manga, video games, and all the incredible swag that's out there. Be a ninja, not an internet pirate, because the only kind of pirates we like around here are what, Naruto?
A pirate.
And I am Gothagara, and I am saying that raw is the best way.
I'm Takashi, and I don't really know. I'm looking up naughty words in Japanese.
I am Naruto, and I am naughty words in Japanese.
Ooh, I'll be over there.
I'm Kakazu, and I just sold Gauze Gold on eBay for expensive cat litter.
I told you to stay the hell away from my eBay page!
I'm Tamari, and man, Goku's really gonna need some Pepto Bismol if he wants to get Naruto through his system.
I'm so sorry, but I'm really incognito. I'm Santa Claus, dammit!
No, Santa's a ninja, and he's with Kakashi's team. Yeah, too late.
I'm Sasuke, and I'm here wishing everybody a Happy New Year.
I'm Pen, and Happy New Year, motherfuckers!
I'm Jiraiya, and it's time to go practice my morning peacock.
Ow!
How are you gonna do that with those acorns?
That's Guy Sensei.
I'm Toby, and I just got done watching the Discovery Channel.
Oh.
So okay, that was my
Wait, it's not just the T-Virus, now he's responsible for AIDS and malaria.
Hey, Toby, was it the giraffes or the elephants?
It was the zebras.
Gotta be the giraffes with those eyelashes, man, seriously. I'm docked, and apparently I want to fuck giraffes, so what?
I don't know how you're gonna get up there, Doctor, the planet's all...
I thought you were going to make a Ninja Turtles reference, but you just kept getting the giraffes.
It kept going. Go visit my site, SSAPodcast.com. I just released a Sailor Moon episode, and Ninja Vanish!
That is it for us. We are signing out. Peace!
Oh, my!
Oh, my! Another sex shitemo. Daijoubu desu ka?
What does that mean, Kakashi?
Will you have anal sex?
I like that Naruto's the one that asked Kakashi.
Yeah.
Hey, Naruto, what are you going to use to do that anal sex?